Well, good morning, everybody. Here it is, a bright Tuesday. It's snowing here where I live. So it's going to be a cold, snowy day. Nice day to be inside. Today I want to talk about the sun and daylight or nighttime on the flat Earth. So my assumption is, or my hypothesis, I guess, is that there's no night, no possibility of night on the flat Earth. So here's my scientific method. Assumptions we have to make: the Earth is flat. Stay with me here. There's a dome, an ice wall at 200 to 400 feet tall. The moon and the sun rotate inside the dome. So if these assumptions are true, my observation is that reflections from a light on a circle form a cardioid. Cardioid I'll show you here in a minute. The hypothesis is there could be no night. In fact, there must be two suns opposite each other at different latitudes. Here is a flat earther's conception of what the day and night would look like on a flat Earth. He said he got this from timeanddate.com. I'm just not sure how you do that, but this is his drawing. I've highlighted a couple of spots here. If you see where the arrow is pointing, that's sunlight down there. So we kind of have a question as to how sunlight gets down there past the dark. Seems to me if it's dark and sunlight is going down to that spot, that causes a problem there for flat Earth. Okay, so here comes a cardioid. Are you ready? This is a cardioid. It's called that because of the dark spot that looks like a heart. So they call it a cardioid. It's created using a mathematical function inside of a circle. And so this is what you get. I don't know if many of you will remember, maybe back in the 60s, there was a toy called a spirograph where you could make these kinds of drawings. This is a cardioid function with two. It has an x squared in it, but you can also have these drawings with 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lobes. Once it gets up past like 200, the function becomes a little different. This guy in the video showed this drawing where there was a light down at the bottom there, and the light shines up toward the top to create this cardioid. The reflections come back at different angles, and which creates this pattern, but it also creates that focal point right there, close to the middle, a little above the middle, and that focal point is as bright as the light, which I thought was very interesting. So let's look at, if we look at the equator here, you can see that the equator is above that focal point. So that focal point on a flat Earth might be somewhere around Mumbai, India, somewhere like that, and around. So as the sun moves around, that focal point will also move around. And let's put the sun on here. There's my sun. So my sun goes around that circle. The focal point will move around. I created this to be similar to the flat Earth picture we just saw. And you can see that maybe there's a dark spot, but it still has some light. And then the daylight spot, and then that focal point. I think that's going to cause a serious problem here for flat Earth. So my conclusion to my little experiment here is that there can be no nighttime on flat Earth. I'm going to give you a little homework here, a thought experiment. So will the sun's light reflect off of the dome, supposing that the Earth is flat? Will we necessarily see two suns of comparable brightness? And would it be possible to have nighttime? I'd like to hear your thoughts on this. And as far as I'm concerned, this is one more nail in the flat Earth coffin, one more shovel of dirt on the grave. So that's all I have for today. Look forward to seeing you on Friday. If everything goes like planned, I want to talk about anti-vaxxers, anti-life. See you on Friday.